Assalamualaikum my dear students, hope you are well by the grace of Almighty Allah. Welcome to NIBS Homeschool. This is Muhammad Imdadul, Assistant Teacher of Mathematics, National Ideal English Version School, Dashift. Dear students, today I am going to take a higher math class of class 9. Our today's topic is Chapter 1, Part 2, Basic Discussion. In this part, I will discuss some important topics from the chapter. The name is Sets and Functions. From this chapter, I will discuss here today union of sets, intersection of sets, disjoint sets, difference of sets, complementary set, and power set. So these are our learning objectives today. Okay, dear students. So let us start. Our first topic is union of sets. Okay, dear students. I have written here at first the definition of union of sets. Suppose A and B are two sets, then their union of sets is A union B. This sign is known as union. This sign is known as union. A union B. A union B is equal to set of all X such that X belongs to A or X belongs to B. It means that if A and B be two sets, their union will be A union B. Their union will be A union B. And elements of the set of their union will be set of all X such that X belongs to A or X belongs to B. It means that the elements contained in A or in B, all the elements we have to include in the set A union B. For this, I can give you an example here. See the example. Suppose A is a set. A is a set. The set A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. B is another set. Suppose here B is 3, 4, A, B. Now, union of A and B will be A union B, A union B. So we can write here the set A, 1, 2, 3, 4. Here give the union sign, then you have to write here the set B, that is 3, 4, A, B. Now, the set of all elements of A or B is combinedly known as A union B. So we have to take all the elements of A and all the elements of B. So take the elements of A at first, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now check the elements of B. Here is 3, I have taken 3. Here is 4, I have taken 4. So no need to take these 3 elements again, as repetition of elements is not possible in set. Just we can write one element only one time. So 3 and 4 I have written here, so no need to write these two elements again. Remaining elements A and B we have to write here. So this is the set which is the union of A and B. Okay, dear students, I hope you have understood how you have to do the union of two sets. Now I'll go to the next topic. What is the next topic here? Now see. The next topic is intersection of set. Before going to the intersection of sets, I want to show the union of sets in a diagram. I have shown the set A, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, A, B. This set is B. Elements of B is 3, 4, A, B, and elements of A is 1, 2, 3, 4. So their union will be the total elements of A and B. 1, 2, 3, 4, A, B. That I have shown in the example. So in figure, we can show the set A and B in this way. There may have common element, but the common elements we have to write just one time. Okay? Now I'll show the intersection of set, intersection of sets. If A and B are two sets, then their intersection of sets is A intersection B. A intersection B. This sign is known as intersection. Intersection. This sign is known as intersection. So if A is a set and B is another set, their intersection will be A intersection B. A intersection B. And this will be set of all X. Set of all X. Such that X belongs to A and X belongs to B. It means that the elements of A and B, which are common, which are common. It means that the elements which will get in A and in E and in B both, that element will contain in A intersection B. Suppose A is a set, I have shown that before, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, B is another set, that is 3, 4, A, 3, 4, A, B. Suppose, now, we have to do A intersection B. So, write here A, 1, 2, 3, 4. Intersection B. What is B here? 3, 4, A, B. Now, intersection means we have to take only the common elements here. In first set 1, there is no 1. So we can take. Here is 2, but there is no 2. So we can take. Here is 3. Yes, here is 3. So 3 is common. So we can write 3. 4, here is also 4, so we can write 4. Then, there is no element here, but here is A and B. But there is no A and B, so A and B is not common element. So, only 3 and 4 is common in both set. So, the intersection of A and B will be 3, 4. Okay, so we can show this in figure. Suppose A is a set and B is another set. Here, the elements of A is 1, 2, 3, 4. Elements of B is 3, 4, A, B. Now, see, in both set, 3 and 4 is common here. So, this portion is the intersection of A and B. This portion is the common. So, 3 and 4 is the elements of their intersection. Okay, dear students, I hope you have understood the topic intersection of sets. Now, I will show you disjoint sets. Two sets A and B are said to be disjoint if their intersection is empty. If their intersection is empty. Here, if A and B are such sets that intersection A intersection B is OE, it means this is empty set, then A and B are called disjoint sets. What does it mean? It means that suppose A equal to set 1, 2, 3, B equal to set 4, 5, 6. If we do the intersection of A and B, here 1, 2, 3, intersection B, 4, 5, 6. Now take the intersection. Intersection means we have to take just common element. As there is no common element, this set will be empty. This set will be empty. This means ORI. So, intersection of A and B is empty. If the intersection of two sets is empty, then the sets are known as disjoints. We can show this in figure. Suppose A is a set. This is set A, B is another set, B is another set. These two sets don't intersect each other. So there is no common element between these two sets. If I write the elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, there is no common element here between these two sets. So their intersection will be empty. And this type of sets are known as disjoint sets. So, set A and B are said to be disjoint here. Okay, dear students, I hope you have understood the Topic disjoint sets. Now I'll show you difference of sets. Difference of sets. Difference of sets. If A and B are two sets, then A difference B is set of all X such that X belongs to A and X not belongs to B. A difference B, this is read as A difference B is called A delete B, and then elements of A that are present in B are discarded from A to form A delete B. A difference B, or we can write A delete B. So we can write here, suppose A is a set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. B is another set. The elements of B are 4, 5, 6, 7. So when we'll determine A difference B, A difference B, or A delete B. This can be read as A delete B. When we'll determine, then we have to write the set A at first, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then give the sign, that is 4, 5, 6, 7. Dear students, to determine this, you need to remember that this set we have to delete. This set we have to delete. It means that no elements of this set will be a member of A delete B. So all these elements we have to discard. We have to discard. Okay. So the elements which are common with the previous set, with the set first one, that elements are also discarded. That elements are also discarded. So we have to cut 4 and 5. So we'll get only 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. So this is the set formed by A and B. A delete B. A delete B. It means I have deleted B from A. Okay? Okay, dear students, I hope you have understood the difference of sets. Now I'll show you the next topic, that is complementary set. Dear students, in the first class I have discussed about universal set. So to discuss complementary set, at first you have to understand the universal set. Universal set means some set we take for the discussion, and all the sets of discussion are the subsets of a set, and that set is known as universal set. Suppose U is a set containing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Suppose A is a set that is 1, 3, 5, 7. Okay, now this set A is a subset of U. This is the set of discussion, and this set is contained in U. So U is the universal set and A is the subset of U. When A is the subset of U, it means universal set, then its complement we can denote it by A prime or A complement. Complement of set can be denoted by A prime or A complement. So we can write the set A complement. A complement. That will be, if we delete the set A from the universal set, we'll get the complement. Delete set A from U. Delete set A from U. You will get the complementary set. So write the set U 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now delete A. A means 1,
3, 5, 7. So if we delete A from U, what will remain here? 1. So 1, 3, 5, 7. These elements matched here. So unmatched elements are 2, 4, 6. These are remaining elements. So this set is the complementary of A. Complementary of A. It means this is A complement. It means that if we delete a set from the universal set, we'll get the complement of that set. Okay, dear students, I hope you have understood the complementary of set. Complementary of set. Now, I'll discuss the next topic, last topic today, that is power set. Dear students, to understand the power set, we need to know about subset. I have discussed subset in the first lecture. So I'm discussing power set now. If I write a set A, the elements of A are, suppose the elements are 1, 2, 3. A has 3 elements. And in the first class, I have told that empty set is a subset of any set. Empty set is a subset of any set. So this is a subset of A, and taking only single element, we can get from here 3 subsets. 1, 2, 3. These 3 sets are also the subsets of A. Then we can form the subset by taking 2 elements. So 1, 2, 1, 2, then 2, 3, 2, 3, and then 1, 3. 1, 3. Now, I have told in the first class that every set is a subset of itself. Every set is a subset of itself. So we can write the set itself also a subset. The set itself also a subset. So I have written here all the subsets of set A. All the subsets of set A. The power set of A can be denoted by PA. Power set of A can be denoted by P of A. Power set of A. This will be equal to the set formed by all the subsets of the set. So at first we have to give a second bracket, and at last we have to close that. It means that if all the subsets of a set are included in one set as element, then that set will be the power set of the given set. Okay, dear students, I hope you have understood. Now see, the set formed by all the subsets of a set A, considering as the elements of the set, is called power set of the set A, and it is denoted by P of A. For this I have written here, all the subsets are contained in a set that is P of A. So P of A is the power set of A. And power set has 2 to the power n elements. 2 to the power n elements. N means the number of elements of set A. N means the number of elements of set A. Number of elements of the set. N means the number of elements of the set. So if we count here 1, 2, 3, 2, 3 elements. So we can write 2 cube means 8. Now count the elements. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So power set has 2 to the power n elements. Okay, dear students, I hope you have understood our today's lecture. Keep practicing at home, abide by your parents, stay home, stay safe. And if you face any problem, then contact with us. We'll try to recover your problem in our live class, or you can contact anytime to solve your problems. Okay, dear students, keep practicing at home, abide by your parents, stay home, stay safe. See you again. Till then, assalam.